The South Coastal Hockey League.
Here come the Rangers trying to make something happen. Bobby Donahoe comes in, shot, score.
Oh, what a beautiful shot.
The South Shore's premier Masters Hockey League.
Scott Kelly coming up the near side, top of the circle. Goal!
Featuring the legends.
Mike Simon go off to the net. Simon, oh, what a save by Rick Kelly. Net Brinkman gets a break, goes to the net and scores. Jerry, come on, Phantom. Oh, we'll pick it up for the Canadiens. 5:20 to go. Harnish in front. Nice maneuver. Martin scored. 9 for second after tonight is Jim Stone. What a save. Across Antoni. The shot. Oh, Jeff Holstein.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey, the game of the week. Two teams will battle it out for a chance to hold the South Coastal Cup. Game on.
It's South Coastal Hockey this week, the pregame show.
Let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team and their guests for some insight into what's happening this week in the South Shore's Premier Masters Hockey League.
It's South Coastal this week, the pregame show.
Brought to you by Fallon Ambulance. We're driven to care.
Now let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team.
Okay, guys, what's up?
It is playoff time in the South Coastal Hockey League, and we've got a dandy for you tonight. It is the Maple Leafs and the Bruins. With Bob Hanner, I'm Mark Ducharme, and Director John Grabowski. We are going to present you with a dynamic game here in the South Coastal Hockey League as we have got who the dance partner is going to be for the winner of this game. We'll tell you about that as the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week here on the South Coastal Sports Network.
This broadcast of the South Coastal Hockey Game of the Week is brought to you in part by underwriting from Inkstone Printing, Commercial Printers of Brockton, Hospitality Mutual Insurance of Westboro, Fallon Ambulance, Rockland Athletic Supplies, Dr. John Parker of the Parker Chiropractic Offices in Hanover, Panera Bread, the Sunshine Pool Company of Pembroke, Frano and Frano, CPAs of Braintree,
the new Schick Hydro for your skin,
That Bloom in Place, Route 53, Pembroke, by Holly Tree Dental in Hanover, and by Stephen Lee Jewelers of Quincy Square.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey, the game of the week.
We just saw a game because the Canadiens not only beat the Blackhawks, they smoked the Blackhawks 4-1. The Blackhawks, who are the Classic's regular season champions, couldn't do much against Jeff Holstein as they only got a goal from Paul Lyons. Kirk Sousa had 2 goals and the Canadiens won. So the winner of this game gets the Canadiens. And we mentioned life like it. Well, in the last 9 meetings between these two teams, that includes the 3 in the season, the Bruins are 7-1-1 against the Maple Leafs. So it's like life is like National Hockey League and the South Coastal Hockey League.
And
same
that goes
thing.
Back, like you said, Mark, a couple seasons, which is, you know, prior to the Bruins, you know, this year they had some key acquisitions offensively that are obviously a big part of this offensive change in statistics going farther. You know, Zimmer and,
Martin.
They didn't have those guys the last few years, but they still continued to beat the Maple Leafs, and the Maple Leafs were always the dominant force in the league. So,
how bad was it as the Leafs try to break out of the zone? And as we have played 45 seconds in this one, Mike Bartlett sees the pass go by him. Young sticks it to the corner. Bruins 8-5, 6-2, and 5-3 were the wins that they had this fall. And Bob said, as far as getting some of the new people to help out, well, they all helped out. Martin, 2 goals and an assist in the first game. Zimmer, a goal and 2 assists. I mean, it was just like that. Second game, Zimmer had 3 goals against the Maple Leafs. The new acquisitions, I mean, I'm thinking that the Bruins, if they want to win this shoot, ought to send Billy Sartell a
Not just head-to-head. Those guys have done a tremendous job all year in putting points on the board for these guys. So the change has been really significant.
Bruins went from a team that, here or there, and made things happen. They just went to a team that just had enough firepower between the two divisions. They were the best team by far as offensive firepower goes. The Leafs, Bob said, one time they were the offensive team, but when you looked at the statistics coming into this one, it's weird. It's like one Leaf player with double-digit points, which is kind of funny to say the least. The Bruins have 4. As a little over 2 minutes play, and we're waiting, for a couple of more shots on net as Andy Pelley leaves it. The Leafs, they're going to try to get this slowed down and get this into a just a ho-hum, grinding type game, because that would benefit them.
Oh, absolutely. Sure.
Jeff Guthrie.
Chop the puck out of the zone. Get the few offensive chances. Try and capitalize. The less time they let the Bruins spend in the offensive zone, boy.
Oh. Guthrie did everything in the offensive zone but couldn't handle the puck. And the circle and ended up losing it. Jack Parsons flicks it ahead. Mudge knocks it down, hit the stick above the shoulders, and no, they will not call it. Bruins back in their own zone. By now, in the games we've watched the Bruins, and as far as this fall season goes, you figure they'd have like about seven shots on net by now. That's how they just fire at will. And you have a lot of people that can do it. Jeff Vancouver, very good defenseman in handling the puck, back in his own zone. As they go with a long pass, Dave Denton knocks it down as it was going for Danny Sloan. Coming back for it, Marty DeCourcy, who was picked up late in the season. Mike Ryan had retired. Marty DeCourcy has come in. He has made things happen. The Don Studley. Back for the DeCourcy. In front, Joe Young grabs it and ties it up. Marty DeCourcy played six games and had 7 points in those six games. And Marty DeCourcy nearly getting on the board as far as this one goes. 8:31 to go, opening period, scoreless. Winner of this game gets the Canadiens in the championship next week. Boy, the Canadiens just dominate. I mean, the Canadiens just love the playoffs. Fallon in, save! Andy Pelley on the breakaway. Peter Fallon, who at one time, when you looked at the Bruins offensively, he was the offense. He's just the third wheel in this offense as he passed it out. DeCourcy knocks it down, clears it out of the zone.
Andy Pelley just doing a great job of just winning that battle. Who budges first? Because Andy just did not move at all. I think Fallon thought he was going to make a move. He was waiting for Andy to go. I think Fallon was thinking Andy was going to move his legs and go five hole. Andy just sat there, and it made it look like a real easy save, but it was not. He just won that mental battle, if you will, because he had a lot of time to think about where he was going to put that puck. He had a clean breakaway from the blue line in.
Zimmer gets a good shot off. Pat save made by Pelley, and Denton clears it out to center ice. Studley grabs it, dumps it in. If you're the Leafs, you got to be going with even shorter shifts, because this Bruins speed with Dugannik, Fallon, and Zimmer is that first line. You're watching it right now. Zimmer in! 1-0 Bruins.
And there's two breakaways, Mark, in the last, 45 seconds of the game?
John Zimmer, the steal, the breakaway, and the goal. And the Bruins on top, 1-0. Zimmer, who led both the Classics and the Legends in scoring with 26 points, went near side and just, boy, did he finish that one off. Pelley never had a chance. As Malloy for Bartlett. Malloy, Bartlett, and Smith, at one time, they were the best line in the Classics division. They led the Classics in scoring three sessions ago, but they have been the second wheel as Bartlett tries to get the Leafs on the board. And I don't know how Joe Young made that save.
I don't know either. I don't know if Bartlett fanned on that. He had it completely wide open there. Joe Young flat on his back, reaching out behind his head with the stick and the blocker, and I don't know even what it hit, Mark, but boy.
Joe Young is just getting
that out. That was either the save of the night or the fan of the night, depending on which way that went.
And a penalty on Jim Smith on top of it. So after the play, Jim Smith gets called for a penalty. We have to have an investigation in this one.
That's his second penalty.
Jim Smith? Who is our executive producer? Make sure that we get on some of our games, get to the network.
Now you talk about pulling rabbits out of your hat. He saved us a few times this year.
Yes,
he
has.
Technical glitches prior to broadcast time. That guy's just got
and the Bruins
tremendous amount of knowledge in this
business. The Bruins decide, okay, we'll be nice to Jim Smith. We'll get a roll penalty. Andy Pelley headed off to the pitch, and for a minute eight, we'll play 4-4. I don't know if that's a good thing as far as everything goes. Bruins see Kevin Sullivan. High stick on Sullivan. So for minute and eight, we have 4-4. I don't know if the Maple Leafs, you want, you would wish you could decline that for one reason. Because if Zimmer, Dugan kept
well,
that
yeah, this
space.
Opens up the ice, I'll tell you.
Gauthier trying to slow
four
down.
4-4 hockey's a lot of fun.
Salvaggio.
As long as you're a forward.
Oh, good grief. Martin tries to tip it around. Mike Martin sends it towards the front. Jack Parsons knocks it down. Parsons for Salvaggio. Mike Martin steals it. It's not bad when your second line forward named Mike Martin has 11 goals and 7 assists for 18 points and played 12 of the 14 games. Not bad. Salvaggio taking it in. Tries to tip in front. And I don't know if Gauthier got a piece of it or not, but the Bruins clear it out. 20 seconds left in the 4-4 situation. As Sloan comes in, Denton knocks it away. Salvaggio trying to knock it out. McGinnis tips it away from him, takes deep into the corner. And Salvaggio ends up with a loose puck with 5:34 to go first period. John Zimmer's goal, it's got the Bruins on top. Joe Young has to knock down that long flick down the ice, so it won't be icing. Sloan, cross ice feed. Denton knocks it down. Gauthier chases after it. Gauthier drops it off. Steve Mudge, who's been hot as of late as far as the Leafs go, dumps it behind the net. Evans puts it on net. Young gets a piece of it. Mudge grabs it. Near side corner. Denton. Let's go of a shot! And Joe Young stayed with the shot as Jeff Gauthier missed getting a tip. But Young stayed with it and ties it up. 5:03 to go opening period. 1-0 Bruins.
Yeah, getting back to your point on Martin. Mark, you got a second line center coming in the top five in the league scoring, not your team scoring, the right. League scoring. Yeah. You know you're doing pretty good.
Wasn't that the way the
talk about depth? That's the kind of depth you want.
Wasn't that the way that was it? The old Edmonton Oilers loved to have it. You know, Gretzky, Messier, Anderson, all
they
those guys.
They just kept coming. Yeah.
Yeah, they just kept coming, and the Bruins are coming. To the net, Pelly, nice grab of that shot by Jimmy Mulhern.
Yeah, I don't know. I thought Mayer might have got a piece of that himself, but Andrew came up with that save.
Now Paul Mayer, Leafs captain, is Harrington wins the faceoff. So we're now 5-on-5. Evans on the breakout, sees the puck go by him. Jim Martin has it for the Bruins. Jim Martin, who at one time was one of the Bruins' better forwards, he's gone back and played defense, and he's doing the job. Snapped off by Don Studley from just at the top of the circle, and it is grabbed by Joe Young and tied up. I keep saying, this forward did this. Kevin Sullivan was a star forward at one time for the Red Wings. Jim Martin was a star forward at one time for the Rangers. Now the Bruin defenseman. You know, it's almost like these guys must be going like, wait a minute, we're demoted? No, we're not demoted. When we feed it out of the zone, we hit a guy like Fallon or Zimmer in stride. Makes life easy. Bartlett and Zimmer on the faceoff, won by Zimmer. Zimmer's had a few titles with the Grizzlies in the old Masters division. Dugenek takes the feed, tries to dump it off. It got deflected, and Fallon almost ended up going down the middle. And Mars knocked it away as Bartlett picks up the loose puck. Up the near side boards, the Bruins steal it and try to start back. It is John Zimmer. Cross ice feed, Mike Maher. One of the steadier defensemen in the Classics division. Rolls it to the front. Bartlett shot goes wide of the net. Rebound towards the front. Young grabs it before Jim Smith can come in and pounce on it. And Young ties it up.
I tell you, I'll talk about putting yourself in a pressure cooker. You know, Joe Young walks into a, you know, it's okay when you're playing to make, you know, filling in for somebody in regular season. There's not a, you know, it's a whole lot of, you still want to do well. But then you walk into a playoff game. And so far, so good tonight for Joe. The Leafs have had a couple really good scoring opportunities, and Joe Young has made some early good saves to keep these guys in the game and obviously give the team that he's playing for some confidence that he can do the job behind him.
Except for that one shift, the Leafs have not played bad here in this first period.
They're still out shooting the Bruins, actually.
Except for that one little shift where they gave up the two breakaway chances as Malloy starts bad. 3-on-2, Malloy flicks it. To the near side corner, Jack Carrig picks it up. Carrig in front, Bartlett tips it on net, and Joe Young got a piece of it. This is getting crazy. Joe Young has come up with some pretty good stops as it's flipped down the other end of the ice. Andy Pelly will have to play it, leave it for Jack Parsons. Bruins able to change up as Parsons look for somebody up the middle and threw it by everybody. Icing in the play, 3:04 to go. First period, winner of this game gets the Canadiens in the championship game of the Classics Canadiens 4-1 win over the Blackhawks. Kirk Souza leading the way with a couple of goals. A beloved, I was looking down our South.
I think they had two empty net goals, too,
yeah,
right, Mark?
So no, they didn't. They didn't count the second one.
Yeah, they didn't. Okay, so it's just a little, this one's a little misleading, but yeah, they certainly, big surprise walking in the rink tonight and seeing the Blackhawks down. And also not seeing Vinicciani in net.
Vinny got hurt.
Yeah.
Vinny hurt his a hamstring coming into the game, and that had the, he was having a marvelous season as Pelly grabs the Riley shot and ties it up. Boy, talk about a second line. John Timpanic, Mike Martin, and Steve Anzoni. That, for some of the teams in the Classics division, would be a first line. Anzoni, blocked by Sean Cleaves. Hall of Famer trying to get free and get the puck out of his own zone, but Anzoni takes it away from behind the net. In front, two saves for Andy Pelly. A third save for Andy Pelly. Andy Pelly had to come up big as Jim Riley got a shot off. As did John Timpanic. And the faceoff will be to the left of Andy with 2:25 to go. John Zimmer's goals get the Bruins on top, 1-0. Waiting for that game on the other rink. Stingers. Sharks will be the late game, but that is the Saints and the Crusaders rematch of the regular season game between those two. The Crusaders won to get in the playoffs after the Whalers lost and their chance to try to get in the playoffs. Stingers took care of that. Stingers, they're the team that's the dark horse in the Legends division. They're scary. They've all of a sudden found their shooting touch.
And I'd say there's a pretty good odds, Mark, that a friend down there, a retired Marine friend in Florida, is will be watching that game tonight live on South Coastal Network.
Yes. He's probably watching it. He's sitting on someplace with a Coca-Cola and relaxing. Marty DeCourcy going to the net. DeCourcy backhanded, blocked by Young. Rebound comes out. Denton goes for the shot. Denton tried for the far corner and couldn't get it. And speaking of former Marine captain, Tony Shaw, who was a Hall of Famer, worked at Harvard. It was a really one of the nicest people you ever wanted to meet as Pelly makes a save off that shot. Tony still laughs at some of the stuff we say about him. He loves it. DeCourcy coming back. Marty DeCourcy, great ball, but he couldn't finish it because Joe Young got a piece of it with a pad with under a minute to go in the period. Marty DeCourcy again swooping around. Boy, Marty DeCourcy just being a... showing why the Leafs have loved having him come into their lineup. Evans tips it back out. Kurig flicks it down low. DeCourcy. What a move Marty DeCourcy made just to get to the net. Evans trying to get it back out to Mike Maher. Now does. Flip shot towards the net. DeCourcy tries to line it up. Second opportunity. DeCourcy with a backhand, a blind backhand. He was hoping to catch the corner. Evans picks it up. Evans in the near side corner. Leafs moving the puck well. Kurig has the shot blocked. Attempt to clear out. Kurig knocks it down. Bruins flip it out of their zone. Leafs have played well except for that one shift, and that one shift right now might be the end of the first period comes up. Is going to be the difference in the first period. John Zimmer steal and breakaway goal. And that particular shift, and the Bruins with a 1-0 lead after one in the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week semifinal matchup in the Classics Division.
Back here on Mark Arena, Mark, playoff hockey at its best so far, so good. We've got a good one here going. Maple Leafs outshooting the Bruins 10-9, a very tightly contested first period. However, one bad shift for the Maple Leafs give the Bruins two breakaways. Andy Pelly was one out of two on those. As a result, where the Maple Leafs are now behind 1-0.
John Zimmer got the goal for the Bruins as Jim Martin clears it out down the other end of the ice and ends up icing the puck. As Zimmer, the breakaway unassisted goal, as that was the only scoring of the first period. Winner gets to play the Canadiens in the championship game next week. We have the Legends Division slated as our game that we're bringing you. Parsons shot blocked. Duganek looks for Fallon on the breakaway. Oh, the Jack Parsons make a nice play. If he doesn't, there's another breakaway chance. Instead, the feed across for Fallon by Zimmer. Just misses connecting. Fallon recovers. Down low for Duganek. Duganek behind the net. It is grabbed. Sean Cleaves sees one Bruin on each side of him. Found a way to get it up the ice. And here come the Maple Leafs. Sean Malloy. Malloy stops, looks, double team. Malloy just took a little too long, but somehow gets it through. Almost got it past the Benedictus. Bartlett was sitting on the doorstep, and if he got it through, would have been a nice situation. And I don't know, do we have a penalty coming up on the Bruins?
It's a late offside.
It's a penalty on the Bruins. Slashing call coming up on the Bruins. Jeremy Converse, Billy Henschy, our referees. And Converse had the call. And let's see which member of the Bruins gets to sit next to the Hammer. That's a penalty enough.
I don't know if they keep stats on this, Mark, but I would imagine that Henschy and Converse have done quite a few games together in this league.
They're one of the better crews.
Yeah, they certainly are.
Yeah. You know one thing. If
but
you're
they got to be in triple digits. I bet they've done, you know, close to 100 games together in this league by now. They've both been around for quite some time.
You know one thing. These guys, the game's under control. It's the Leafs. Power play. They tie it. Dave Salvaggio. Was it tipped by Jeff Gauthier? Or is it Salvaggio getting the goal?
Yeah, I was going to see what the scoring looks like because, yeah, it doesn't look like.
But it's a power play goal.
It doesn't look like Joey even saw the puck, but either way. Even if somebody did get a piece of it or not, Joe was had a really pretty good. Maple Leafs did a really wonderful job of screening him, so he had no shot of that. No shot on that shot, regardless of whose stick it came off.
Salvaggio from Mudge, so Gauthier didn't get a piece of it, but Gauthier has been around in front of the net a couple of times in this one, and he's caused some problems. And the Leafs tie it at one. Here in the second period, as Mayer trying to get the puck out. So the Martin penalty, 17 seconds old when the Leafs are able to get the great chance. Salvaggio on the, from the circle, putting one in as Leafs ice the puck and a 1-1 tie. 9:55 to go, middle period.
Yeah, Beal saw that coming. He was gone off to the races too, but he just cut inside. Puck came off the boards and came up far enough. Otherwise, that was another really good opportunity.
I don't know. We have another situation where the lower seeds, it's their night. That's the one thing about this league. As Martin lines went up, and Andy Pelly took a bullet in the chest. Oh, man, that hurt. Just watching. Tied it up. He had the near side covered, but, I mean, Mike Martin just fired a bullet.
Maybe a little frustration on that penalty he just took. They get a goal, he comes out on the ice and puts a little extra wood on that because, yeah, Andy certainly felt that one.
I like to go back and look at the number of times that the it's got to be a very high percentage with the underdogs as far as winning games go. The Leafs know about that. The year that they came in with just one loss in the regular season, they get knocked out in the playoffs. Lead by the Rangers, and it was crazy to say the least. As Anzoni on the breakout pass to Panic, coming up the near side to Panic, his help from Martin. Martin tries to shovel it down low, does. Anzoni will pick it up. On the right side, Anzoni dumps it behind the net. Marr grabs it. Marr looking for Evans and trying to get out of the zone. Dave just pries it away from Jeff Vancura and comes back. Evans fires it near side. Young grabs it, ties it up.
Ooh.
Evans. Steve Anzoni. The more mellow Steve Anzoni. In the past, he probably would have gone after Dave Evans. That's the one thing. Jeff Vancura, I always remember him in this league as a defenseman, and still is a defenseman. Tom Drame was a forward. Kevin Sullivan was a forward. Jim Martin was a forward. They're now back on defense. That's the Bruins' back line. It's like Who in the Bruins hasn't had a chance? I mean, Drame was a leading scorer at one time. In fact, when the Bruins won their first of their two titles, Drame was their leading scorer. Vancouver trying to ask Jeremy Converse. I didn't ice the puck, did I? Mulhern, Bartlett on the faceoff to the left of Joe Young as Malloy get tied up by Sloan and allow Mulhern to get the puck. Drame tries to go up the middle and it skips over Jack Carrig's stick. Andy Pelly smartly ties it up with Tom McGinnis bearing down upon him. Waiting for that Crusaders Saints score if we'd like to give it to you. Give you an idea who one of our teams will be next week for the finals. This fall season's really flown by. Drame rolls one towards the net. Jack Parsons zaps it out of the zone and ices the puck. Now, you know Jeremy Converse is not like older brother Dave. Because that's what, three icing calls in this period? Dave only limited, I mean, I always remember the old Pete Senator line. What was it? One icing call, but that was a season.
Or a month at least.
Yeah, it was a month at least. I mean, that used to be the old Pete Senator line. Hey, the only time Dave Converse ever called an icing, it was because he needed to take a breather. Cleaves get tackled
Boy,
on the play.
I'll say, yeah.
Harrington brought it in. Bartlett offsides. Now the Bruins gave up the power play goal by Dave Salvaggio that has tied this game. 7:56 to go in the middle period. And this game has got a nice Leaf tempo to it.
Yeah, they've certainly got to like how this game has developed so far.
Pace is perfect. The Benedictus and the Bruins. Sloan coming back up the near side. Nice move to get around Parsons to take it into the corner. Sloan tries to set up. Parsons recovers, knocks it away, but McGinnis comes in, snaps it out. Pelly tips it out. The Benedictus got the shot off.
Boy,
a screen.
I don't know.
I'm trying to figure out if he did or not. The Benedictus will line up another one. This time he has it blocked by Bartlett. Great backhand feed to Malloy, and Malloy just never got it cleanly. If Malloy got it cleanly, he's off to the races. Jim Martin has it for the Bruins. Leafs trying to get back out there because it'll allow Fallon to come in on the break. Fallon puts the Bruins in front.
Wow.
And a bad line change for the Leafs cost them. Fallon from Martin, and the Bruins take a 2-1 lead.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if that puck went in. May have got deflected a late, possibly off the defenseman. Really bad angle shot for Fallon, even though it was almost a breakaway. But defenseman made a great play in getting back, dove in front of that shot. And either Andrew lost sight of it, or it could have even gone off as a defenseman and went in the net. Because Andrew had that whole side pretty well covered.
Boy, Andy Pelly has been doing everything that you could ask of him. That one really was kind of tough for him. All two of the four Bruins key players at the offensive end of the ice have made things happen in this one. Salvaggio coming in. Oh, what a move! Oh. But he couldn't pull it through and get it on the forehand. If he did, it was a 2-2 game. Salvaggio did everything he could ask, but didn't finish off the play. Zimmer back. Duganek curls at the circle, drops it to the corner. Zimmer grabs it. Zimmer back for Duganek on the diagonal feed as it gets off his stick. And back into the Bruins zone. 6:10 to go, middle period. Lawrence Healy for the Bruins. For Peter Fallon. Fallon looking. Fallon in front for Duganek. Block. Now the Bruins were changing up the defense pairing. And the Leafs never could get the control of the puck. And if this guy ever got control of the puck with him changing up the defenseman. It would have been interesting. Marty DeCourcy, who had a great rush to the net. Maher tries to keep it in. Maher had it knocked away. Martin starts back in. Zoni comes up to join him on a 2-on-1. Martin shot, block. Pelly has it in the pads and ties it up. And we said about a, I would say, what, 3 minutes ago, we were saying, oh, this is Leafs pace.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Not anymore.
Yeah, I'm not sure if Martin saw Anzoni coming into that plate to him, because he certainly would have passed that puck over him, because Martin is certainly not a selfish player. I don't think he saw Anzoni come, because Anzoni was wide open in front of that net for a nice, easy pass.
All of a sudden, it is becoming more of a Bruins pace. As Maher dumps it down into the Bruins zone, Tommy Drommy knocked away. David Evans tries to get it in front. Tim Panic knocks it away. Maher trying to keep it in. Vancouver chips it away. But Martin back for Vancouver. Tim Panic joins the play, but the puck gets knocked away. Jack Couric trying to get control. Anzoni headed for a moment. Now the Leafs do get control. Lead pass. Harrington trying to run into the feed. Harrington does try to throw it in front. Nobody in a blue shirt there. As Vancouver in the home white of the Bruins starts back. John Timpanic. Backhand feed across, and the Leafs are all there.
Oh, look out.
Malloy.
Oh, man.
Boy, Sean Malloy is
just
he
got a hold of that
night.
Pass, boy, he was gone again.
Sean Malloy.
Bruins doing another poor job of changing their lines right there. Maple Leafs doing a poor job of changing their lines.
Well, the Maple Leafs have just made it hard on themselves. Jimmy Smith comes up with the puck. Smith feeds to the middle, but the Bruins back checking, doing the good job as Dan Sloan comes back. Sloan brings it in. Sloan slowed down on the play. Puck comes out of the leaf zone. John DeBenedictis picks it up and just throws a bad pass into the Bruins bench. 3:55 to go here in the middle period. 2-1 Maple Leafs down to the Bruins. Everybody was, we're joking upstairs prior to the game. We're saying if the Leafs come back and win this one, with the way they have dominated the Canadiens, we should just award the Leafs the cup right now.
Yeah. They may just email them a victory over the week.
The funny story about that is what? Is a lot of the Leafs and the Canadiens all live in Marshfield, and they're all good friends, and they all give each other a hard time about it. The Leafs players give the Canadiens a hard time about it as the Benedictus' shot gets deflected wide. It's Tom Lehman one time says, it's our turn to win. I can remember Dave Evans was saying this thing. It's our turn to win. And all of a sudden, the Leafs come out, win late in the game, and that was frustrating.
We got a penalty here.
Not what the Leafs want.
Well, they don't need that right now.
Who gets to sit next to Jim Hanley in the penalty box? Our timekeeper, Hall of Fame timekeeper. No, it's going to be Jack Parsons.
Okay.
Body check and a no check league on Jack Parsons and the Bruins. First power play, they hope. The last one they started on, then they drew a penalty. Dugannik near side shot. Black Pelly cleared away and
right to John Zimmer.
And John Zimmer says, thank you.
Thank you very much for that one, yes.
Power play goal for John Zimmer. Second goal of the night, and the Bruins up 3-1.
Interesting thing here is, well, the ref's going to really rub it in and give Andrew an assist on this.
Well, Andy always says he wants to control the puck. Unfortunately for Andy, it wasn't Andy's fault.
No, it certainly wasn't. Just
Evans. And the one thing it's showing, I think, Bob, is the fact that for each mistake that the Leafs have made, the Bruins have made them pay. Power play.
Yep.
And they get the opportunity and score.
Bad line change.
Score.
Breakaway score.
Yeah. That's all it is. three mistakes, actually, or the four big mistakes that the Leafs have made, and there's the difference. And the Leafs trying to change it around. Studley nearly got Evans going free into the net. Fallon off the long feed, can't get to the puck. Mayer gets to it, 2:15 to go here in the middle period. The Leafs had tied the game. Now the Bruins have taken advantage of a couple of mistakes by the Leafs to take a 3-1 lead. Riley back in his own zone, skates right in front of Joe Young.
I thought he was almost going to backhand it on the net there for a second. Almost hopped over his stick.
That would have been... Hey, well, we feel sorry for you. We'll let you get back into the game. Trommy back in his own zone. Mike Martin comes back. Pelly kick save. Mayer clears it out of play. It was funny. Last week, I was talking to Jim Smith. He came upstairs. We were just talking. And I said, you know, congratulations. You beat the Blackhawks and so forth. He says, I don't know if that's a good thing or not because we were going to get the Bruins instead. I think Jim was right. It has been a bad matchup. Said the Bruins coming into this one, of the last nine games have won seven of them against the Leafs. They're 7-1-1. In the last nine against the Leafs. Bartlett and the Leafs trying to come back. Drommy has the puck go off his stick. Smith trying to create something in the offensive zone as he beat Drommy, kicks it free to himself. Jim Smith trying to crawl around, gets help from Chris Harrington. Great feat!
Oh,
Mike Bartlett!
He fanned on it.
Fans on the first time, then Jim the second
got a
shot
second
in
whack
the show.
At it too, yeah.
Mike Bartlett is going to just, on the ride home tonight, I don't want to be the person
wow,
that's driving
yeah.
near him because Mike Bartlett got robbed by Joe Young, had an open net, and just fanned on it, and then got the second opportunity, jammed it into Joe Young. Mike Bartlett could have two goals already in this one as he wins the faceoff. However, tried to slide it across the end zone. Great lead pass to Mike Martin.
Put a little extra...
As looking for Anzoni on the trail, and Anzoni gets stoned by Andy Pelly. You know, this is the kinder, gentler Steve Anzoni. Have you noticed that? He goes over, pats Andy on the back. Before Steve would have probably, you know, the former Wolf in the old Masters Division would have grumbled and growled, and, you know, he would have said something going by. No, Steve is good. Steve's one of those players you want on your team. And you hate playing against.
Steve, Marchand and Anzoni.
Yes.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Just, I got a ton of respect for the guy. Played against for a lot of years. And you always knew that when he was on the ice with you, that you had to work. You didn't get anything for nothing. You had to really work. And he made you, you knew it.
I like Steve Kincaid.
And he did it cleanly, too. Yeah. He's not dirty.
No. Bruins claiming that faceoff should be outside the zone. Mulhern guilty on the faceoff. Mudge gets bumped into by McGinnis. Mudge knocks down an attempted pass up the boards. Backhand shot near side. Save Joe Young. He's got the pad down on it. Cleaves couldn't keep it in. As now Parsons comes around. 12 seconds to go in the period. Maybe one last chance if the Leafs push it. They do. Gauthier, nice idea to go across ice. Salvaggio couldn't get to the pass because the Benedictus and Martin knocked it away. The second period will come to an end. The Leafs tied the game on a goal by Dave Salvaggio on the power play, but the Bruins answer with goals by Peter Fallon and John Zimmer and go to the third with a 3-1 lead in the semifinal matchup in the Classics Division.
Back here, Hob Mark Arena after two periods of play. Mark, shots on goal, second period. The Leafs outshooting the Bruins again, 7-6, two period totals. 17 for the Leafs, 15 for the Bruins. But I'll tell you, the Bruins make it count when they shoot the puck and get their chances because right now they're leading this hockey game 3-1.
With Bob Hanna, Mark Deshaun, Director John Grabowski, guiding us along the way in this second period. Saw the Bruins cash in on two Leafs mistakes, and they try to force the Leafs into another mistake. That's why they have the 3-1 lead, as Peter Fallon on a semi-breakaway broke the 1-1 tie, and then John Zimmer on a power play chance got the Bruins after Andy Pelly made the original stop, and he tapped it right to Zimmer as Peter Fallon just walked out in front, nearly made it 4-1 on top of it. John Zimmer, let's get two of the goals. Peter Fallon has got the other one, and they head off the ice after that successful 43-second first shift of the third period. We're going to the Legends Championship game next week, trying to get that Crusader-Saints score, so we'll at least know one of the teams in that final. We know that the Canadiens are in the Classics final as a save off Anzoni by Andy Pelly. Kevin Sullivan pulls it back in his own zone. Tim Panic. Wonder if the Canadiens are kind of, I don't know, who do you root for? The team that has dominated you for the last 3 years, or the team that is probably, when they get going offensively, they're scary.
Well, yeah, the good thing about it, if that matchup does work itself out, I mean, you know that all the guys in the ice can have a blast playing each other.
Oh.
Because, like you said, the give and take between these guys during the season, and if the, you can imagine the stuff going back and forth just this week alone before the game.
Evans fed it in front and get deflected right into Joe Young. If you're the, you know, the Bruins who are just exploded when they get Martin and Zimmer and made things happen. Or do you want to see the Canadiens? I mean, you know, the Leafs, as Abe Evans is shot! Found its way in! It trickled up and over the shoulder of Joe Young and went into the net. And, well, the Leafs are back in this one.
Boy, and that empty, that field empty net goal end of last period is looming large right now, isn't it, Mark? Looking at a 3-3 hockey game right now.
Oh, and that makes it interesting. Marty DeCourcy winning the faceoff, getting to Dave Evans. Oh, Marty DeCourcy with a faceoff win. We said that he's been a big factor for the Leafs. Leafs now within one. Evans' shot just trickled up and over Joe Young's shoulder. Bruins coming back, 10 to go in the regulation. Martin trying to change things around. Martin shot, blocked Andy Pelly. Evans grabs it. Now we had to tell you, as far as the overtime setup goes, wait for the next faceoff to try to tell you how the all overtime situation goes. It's DeCourcy, two line offside. If we end up at the end of regulation in a tie, we go 5-minute overtime, and after 5 minutes, if nothing happens, we go to the shootout to determine who advances on. That has been the new rule, and because we've had in the past, remember, the Masters game we had one year, was it the Grizzlies and I think it was the Thunder. I think we were here until almost midnight.
Yeah.
I don't know, John, you didn't direct that game. I think it was Joe Callahan. Yeah, Joe Callahan, we had to, you know, we had to give Joe Callahan a couple of cups of coffee as far as that one goes to keep him awake. Because that one was, and for us too, because that one, it was up and down the ice. One of the longer games we ever had. Maher back in his own zone, curls around, pass up the far side, knocked down Dan Sloan, did a great job, and I don't know about that one being offsides. I thought Sloan knocked down the puck inside the league zone. 9:17 to go, regulation. Bruins, who had a 3-1 lead coming into this period, now up by one, 3-2. And Jim Smith chasing after the puck with Lawrence Healy. Smith trying to get it in front for Sean Malloy. Back out instead to Mike Maher. Maher in front, Bartlett! Mike Bartlett's going to have... I don't want to be driving next to Mike Bartlett on the ride home. I do not want to drive next to Mike Bartlett. That's three great opportunities for the veteran forward.
He's already won the truck award.
Yeah.
The swift play of the week. The swift play of the night.
It's a swift sign of the times, yeah. Mike Bartlett.
Well, the not-so-swift play of the night.
Mike Bartlett's had a frustrating night.
Yeah, that puck was bouncing. He did a good job of getting that, actually. Keep just trying to settle it and get a shot on net, but it just...
Andy Pelly doing a heck of a job. And
the
Mike
hits keep
Maher.
Coming. Oh.
Mike Maher, and we got a little disagreement. Mike Maher didn't like the way one of the Bruins was around.
Andrew's going to break his ankle if he didn't get that stick out of there.
Yeah, and Andy Pelly ends up with a stick and his skates. Maher's going to be going off. He's going to have
help. I think
they're
probably both going off.
Yeah. McGinnis, I think, is the other one. Maher did not like the fact that Andy had company. Oh, does it appear it's going to be just Mike Maher?
Yeah, no.
No, roughing.
Yeah.
Maher and McGinnis both going off. Five on five is Andy Pelly. Got one.
What a save.
Andy Pelly got a John Dugan a tip that just died on him, and he was able to hang with it because that thing had movement, and all of a sudden it just had a flat push to it at the end of the shot. Andy Pelly, one great save. Dugan a kick save, Pelly. Fallon tries to get it in front. Harrington knocks it down. Parsons tries to clear it out and does. Bruins trying to get the two-goal cushion back and nearly do. Parsons through the middle, broken up on the play. Martin, Jim Martin for the Bruins. Cut down at the blue line by Salvaggio. He's got one of the two Leafs goals. Salvaggio trying to come back one on two. Salvaggio looking for somebody to come with him in a blue shirt. Flips it towards the front. Boy, Cleaves got dumped on the play, got tripped. As Studley tries to flip one and goes high and off the crossbar. Oh, he just rattled one. He caught Joe Young going down in the butterfly and hit the crossbar. And then Denton golfed one up into the stands. The Leafs' luck tonight is not good at all. That was one time Joe Young got beat and that thing. That shot by Don Studley just ringed off the crossbar. 7:36 left. Boy, the Leafs are going to have... They don't tie this one. There's going to be a lot of people just shaking their heads what if, what if?
There'll be plenty to think about, exactly.
The only good
Certainly
news...
not is, for lack of effort.
No, only good news for the Leafs is the fact that the winter slash spring season will be a couple of weeks away. But they would like to be playing next week, and the Bruins also naturally want to play next week. They have the 3-2 lead, 6:55 left, as Timpanic. Good feed in front! Pelly, what a save on Mike Martin! Andy Pelly right now is the reason that this is only still just a 3-2 game. As DeCourcy takes the feed. Back for Studley in the pass. Just bounced over a stick. Boy, Andy Pelly is sharp tonight. Sullivan back in his own zone. Joe Young's played well, too. This has been a good playoff game. And Sony. For Timpanic, and the Leafs didn't have exactly the best line change, and then Denton loses his stick on top of it. Sloan, so it's basically a 5-on-4. The shot, Pelly, the kick save. Malloy gave Denton his stick. Malloy's a right-handed shot, and he gave Denton the stick, and it was a lefty. Denton picks up him with a
smart play by Malloy. Give the defenseman the stick.
Let the defenseman do it. Bartlett. Malloy went back and got another stick from somebody else. That's Dave Denton's stick on the ice in the Leafs zone. Jack Carrig tries to tip it out. Loose puck, it is going to be the Bruins. Mulhern trying to pass it in front. Malloy got a new stick. And his breakout pass goes by everybody. Drymy will go back in his own zone. 5:25 left in regulation. 3-2 Bruins. Leafs control at center ice. Harrington snaps it off. Young knocks it down. As Young leaves it, and the Bruins try to start out. It is going to be Sloan. Slow down Mudge. Mudge, who had a good finish to the regular season, can't get it up the ice. Carrig will try his pass knocked down. Carrig. Now Gauthier. Harrington now rolls it down, and Joe Young. Boy, did he make sure that
I'll
he
say,
knocked
yeah.
that one down. That was one of those, I'm going to make sure that I block this one. He wasn't going to be nonchalant. 4:55 left in regulation. 3-2. Bruins with the lead. John Zimmer's power play goal is second of the night right now. The difference. Duganek can't get it around Carrig. Leafs trying to pinch in the offensive zone. Create. Marr, nice move, tried to roll it through. Of the Bruins, grab it, 4:35 left. As the breakout pass, and here come the Bruins. On the move, it is John Zimmer. Saps it off, and Andy Pelley comes up with the glove. And he ties it up. No matter how this ends, this is one of Andy Pelley's better performances. Really is, especially in this period.
He's played extremely well all night long. And like you said earlier, both goalies have, actually. It's just... there's a lot of firepower out here, and these guys are holding their own for sure.
Oh, are they ever. Parsons flicks it out. Fallon. Well, this is a good matchup of lines here. Evans, DeCourcy, Studley out there. Zimmer, Fallon, Duganek for the Bruins. These two lines are going to see each other in the final 4 minutes. Oh, great deal. Fallon, slow down DeCourcy. Around the boards, it's Studley. Studley will go to Jack Parsons. Parsons flips it by.
I'm stunned by that because
I thought Kevin Sullivan could have knocked it down.
He tried. Certainly tried, and he missed.
Oh, yeah. 3:43 left. John Zimmer, two goals. Peter Fallon, the other one. Leaf goals. Dave Evans and Dave Salvaggio. Timpanic rolls it towards the net. Pelley knocks it down. Mayer clears it out of his zone. Bruins trying to knock it back in. Denton will end up with a deflected shot. Denton for Mayer. Mayer flips it past Timpanic. Smith keeping it in for Malloy. Back for Smith. Smith tied up in the play. Vancouver sends it around the boards. Mayer barely kept it in the zone. Flips it towards the far corner. Bartlett looking for Denton. Denton ends up with it. Denton rolls it towards the net. All the Leafs were tied up in front and allowed the Bruins to start with a long lead pass. Martin in. Martin gets tied up.
And he gets slapped. They're going to call Denton on a
slash. That is a bad call.
Boy, I don't know about that. I don't know about that.
2:55 left. Dave Denton for a slash. Bruin power play. They're 1-for-2. I do not know if I would have called that one.
Yeah, it doesn't look like he's complaining much either, so.
Now, John Zimmer just got a power play goal in the second period for the Bruins. They have a power play here in the third, and doesn't leave the Leafs a whole heck of a lot of time if they kill this one off. So they might be a little offensive-minded. Bartlett will try to be offensive-minded coming up the near side. Bartlett with 2:38 left, a minute 12 to go on the penalty. Bartlett and has help from Marr. Marr along the boards. Marr can kill off a little time, but you would like to get a face-off down in the Bruins zone if you could. Over the Bruins able to take it away. Bartlett not able to slow down the Bruins as they break out of their zone. As Anzoni slowed down finally by Malloy. And now dumped down behind the net. Andy, whoops!
Uh-oh.
That's a rarity. Andy's an excellent skater. Healy, shot deflected. Malloy chases after it with Sloan. Minute 53 left in regulation. 3-2 Bruins. They're on the power play for 24 more seconds. Healy has a shot blocked. Race for the loose puck. It's Mulhern. Shoots it towards the crease and goes by the crease. And Malloy picks up the puck on the right wing side. Malloy flips it out. 1:35 left. 10 seconds to go on the penalty to Denton. You know Dave Denton is going to be out
there
for the final
shift. He's
going to
be a happy guy. Yeah. I'll tell you, the Bruins haven't got a shot on goal yet of this penalty. So
as it's cleared down, will it be an icing? No, it won't be. 1:20 left. The Leafs want to get organized. They've used their timeout. They want to get Andy Pelley out. Harrington dumps it down. Mayer rings it off the boards for Harrington. Bruins steal. 1:07 left. Nice move to take it in. Fallon slowed down. Jack Parsons. Parsons tried to get it to Mudge, rolls it all the way down. And
Andrew's
got to
get
plays.
Out of that. I don't know what he's waiting for.
Pelley. Mayer says, get out of here. Get
exactly,
to the bench.
Yeah.
Mayer just looked over his shoulder and said, Andy, get to the bench quickly. We need the sixth skater out there. Leafs trying to keep it in the offensive zone. And now the lead offside's waved off. Lead pass. Marr knocks it down. Marr in the middle for Mudge. Mudge just rolls it ahead. Joe Young grabs it and ties it up. 30 seconds to go. 3-2 in favor of the Bruins trying to hang on. Bruins trying to hang on. Get to the championship game.
Now's the time for the Maple Leafs call a timeout and figure out what they want
to
do
here. They used the timeout.
Oh, they already did, yeah.
Leafs trying to get this game tied into overtime. Bruins trying to hang on, get to the championship game. DeCourcy. Well, Billy Hinchy's get tired of Marty DeCourcy and John Zimmer on that faceoff. Now we'll try with Jeff Gauthier. DeCourcy moves over. One by the Bruins. 25 seconds left. Cleared down. Is this going to be icing? It will take a few seconds off. 20.1 seconds left in regulation. John Zimmer, 2 goals. Peter Fallon, 1 for the Bruins. Leafs, Dave Salvaggio, Dave Evans. Leafs keep changing up who that sixth player is. They had Bartlett out for that little 10-second flurry. Now it's Sean Malloy. Marty DeCourcy, he's just playing traffic cop out there. No, you go here. No, you go there.
I don't know why he wants him over there. He's a right-handed shot. You put the guy in front of the net.
Well, Studley rolled down. Will it be a 4-2?
Oh, boy.
Game time as far as this one goes. The empty netter. And the Bruins head to the championship game.